Welcome to Ekidel, where we train future civil and structural engineers. My name is Fashe Ochet. Today, we want to look at how we can do some settings in our protastructure. That's prota settings. But this type of setting, we are going to concentrate on how to rearrange our members. And this rearrangement is going to help us to reduce the stress when it comes to prota detailing. You notice that at times, in the course of modeling, you discover that maybe as you're modeling, for example, if you look at this, this is my plan view. If you look at this, my plan view, sorry, it's coming up. If you look at this, my plan view, in the course of modeling, maybe there's a particular member, for example, where my cursor is, maybe it's having a problem. And this problem, how can it be resolved? Don't forget that before deleting this member, it has a number tagged to it. So this number, by the time I delete it, you discover that placing it back is going to be another number. Let's assume the total number of beams here is, let's say, is a 20, for example. And by the time I delete this one, and replace it, this particular beam here, we discover it's going to give me 21. Or name it even less. Maybe before this is beam 10. And maybe by the time I now put it, it's giving me maybe beam 14. For example, don't forget we have beam 40 before. So, or maybe it's 20, and now it's now 21. So in a real sense, we discover that in the course of modeling, sorry, in the course of prota detailing, by the time you export to AutoCAD, you discover you'll be finding it difficult to relocate this particular beam. And you know that when it comes to detailing, you discover there's a way we names our beams. You know, for example, beam 1, beam 2, beam 3, beam 4, and you know how we, you know, make arrange our beams. Then before we now come to this, we first of all deal with horizontal, then we now come to what? To vertical. So all this problem, you need to see how we can solve it. Likewise, our columns. These are columns. By the time maybe you have deleted, for example, this one is having an issue, and you delete this particular member of this So maybe you delete this particular member here. And because of deleting it, it has a name. And this name, how can you replace it back that it will give you accurate number? That by the time you are looking at your columns, it gives you the correct numbers. Likewise, your beam and your slabs. So for example, if this slab has an issue, and you delete it. After deleting it, don't forget before deleting it, it has a figure, a number tagged to it. By the time you delete and place it back, you discover that the number of your slab will keep on increasing. Whereas, in a real sense, it's not supposed to be. So how do you rectify that? That is why we are here in Ekidel. Ekidel is a place where we train engineers and structural engineers. So therefore, Ekidel is a place I would advise you to be. And we have this Ekidel mentorship class where we train specially people who are ready to, who want to be especially good in terms of structural design. And in case you have not subscribed to our Ekidel channel, I would advise you to subscribe so that you can be getting our subsequent videos. There are a lot of videos we have done on structures from protastructure. And in case in terms of detailing, we have done a lot using a stone bridge detailing catalog. And we have 2024 version of it, which is the latest version. It's a wonderful software, and this software called Stonebridge, if either you are using Orion, either you are using a Start Pro, and in fact, it's very, very fantastic. That's what we use. And at the same time, I want to advise you, in case you have not given this video a thumbs up, please do that. And don't forget to subscribe to our video. So as I've said, we want to see how we can, you know, reduce the stress when it comes to detailing. You discover that in after prota detailing, there are times you find it difficult to locate your members. Why? Because they are not properly arranged. So that's what we are going to be concentrating. By part two of this, we now see how we can reduce the stress on removing some dimensions that are not necessary in the course of our editing in AutoCAD and also in a Stonebridge template detailing. So it's very important to follow us on this particular prota setting. Part one is first of all to see how we can rearrange our members, to re-level them so that we can have, in terms of locating our members, we will not find it difficult. And at the same time, some dimension that are not needed, which is going to be part two, we can remove those dimension right from prota structure so that we can meet up with clients. Before you know it, like this structure and just a story building, before you know it, within some hours, we are done modeling, designing, and all of that. So that's what we are going to be concentrating. So let's go further and see how this can be rectified. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, Ekidel. So it's a place to be, and also have a Ekidel group whereby all the engineers in the whole world, that's as in fact within the country, outside the country, where we relate. So if you follow our channel, you can also be part of it. If you have any question, you can ask, and if anybody asks question that you have the idea to the answer to, we have answer to it, you can also, you know, give out your idea. It's a place whereby we don't hide our knowledge. Knowledge is very, very important. So let's dive in and see how we can do those settings on our members, part one. Welcome back once again. As we have said, we want to see how these members can be, you know, properly arranged. For example, you will notice that in the course of modeling, there are members that maybe is having an issue, or in the course of modeling, you discover that you made a mistake, you delete after inserting a particular beam. For example, this beam is not, I've already put this beam here, and I discovered that it's not supposed to be here, and it's supposed to be maybe in here on this grid line here. Maybe there's a grid line here. I mistakenly put the beam here instead of putting it here. So I delete this one, I come and put this one. You discover that since I've already placed this beam here, I've placed the beam here, you discover that it has a number attached to it. So if I now delete it and now come here, it will not repeat the same number. No, it will add just like one after one is what? Is two. Alright. Let's assume this one is four, where you know you have already placed is four. And now you made a mistake, you are now delete it, and now this is the right place to place it. And now place this one. It's not naming as four, it's going to name it as five. You see? So the number of beam you delete and you are inserting, the number will keep on increasing. Likewise, not only beam, likewise your slab and your columns. So now how do we rectify it? So we want to see how we can do that. As I said, in case you have not subscribed to our Ekidel channel, please, I would advise you to do so, so that you can have more of our videos in order to see that yes, your work is properly, you know, you enjoy designing in Protastructure. So now let's now see how this can be solved. So let's see how this one can be solved. So let's zoom it and see. So as you can see it here, as you can see this beam here now. So based on this, this beam is beam one, story one, isn't it? So now that it's beam one, story one, let's assume we made a mistake. I want to rectify it. So therefore, let's delete it and see what it's going to give us. So let's delete this beam and see what it's going to give us. So let me delete. Delete, are you sure? Yes. So now I've just deleted this beam now. So come up. As you can see, it has been deleted. So now let's now place it back. Don't forget, it's beam one, what? Story one, beam one, isn't it? So now let's see how we can place it back. So let me use the same property of this. Let me use it to place this beam back here. So property, come up. I'm going to use the same property to place this beam and see what it's going to label it as. So now let's start from here to this place. Now let's see what we're going to have. So you can now see that beam, story one, beam one, is now giving us, it's now telling us it's what? 62. As you can see, story one, beam 62. Whereas that means that the number of our beam is what is increasing. So at the end, maybe you have made a lot of some corrections on beams, number keep on increasing. So when you're now looking for beam one, beam two, you discover that you'll be wondering, and if you talk of beam 62, you'll be thinking that based on your knowledge of how to arrange beams, your beams, you'll be going far from whereas something is very, 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 very close. Have we done this? Now let's look at our column two. Let's see, this story one, column one, isn't it? So let me also delete this one and let's place it back. Let's see, there's anywhere, maybe there's a particular column that's not necessary, or there's a particular column that you discover that it's having an issue. I want to delete and place it back. Let's see how we can also do that. Let's see this one. Let's assume this one. Let me delete. Okay, deleted. Don't forget column one, story one, column one, isn't it? So let me take the properties of this particular one, the properties of this one, and place it back. And let's see what we are going to have. Let's place it back. Let's come up. So let's place it back. Good. So what are we having now? Let it come up. You see, column 41. Whereas this is column one. So you can see what we are talking about. So here, this is column one, but now because we have deleted it, and now we are placing it back, so it's not going to target as column one, story one. It's going to, number is going to increase. So that is that concerning a column. Now let's look at what about slab. Let's see the slab. So you can see this slab two, story one, slab one, isn't it? Story one, slab one. So let's delete this one and now see what is going to give us. Let me delete this slab. Delete. Okay. Let's delete it. So we have deleted it. So let's now take the property of this particular slab and place it back. We are going to make use of the property of this and to place our slab back here. So then when we have done this, let's now see how everything can be arranged so that by the time we get to our proto detailing, it's not be difficult for us to do what? To locate our members. So now let's see what we have. You can see now slab what now? 24. So you can see story one, slab 24. Whereas before it was story one, slab one. So these are the things we are talking about. So let's assume this one is here. Let's now go to our, let's say, roof beam. Let's see, we also adjust some things and let's see how everything is going to be arranged. So let me look at my story. Let me show to my story roof beam and see. So this is my roof beam. So you can see this one. This one is still giving us what? Story two, beam one. So now let's now delete. Let me assume this one. Let's delete this one and see. Let's delete this one. Let's delete this one and see what it's going to give us. Let's just delete this one. Let's delete this one. Okay, so let me use the property of this one to place it back. Let me use property of this one to place this one back. So and see what it's going to give us. So there are times you make some adjustments, all of those things. If it's from story 1 to story 100, everything will be properly what? Arranged. So let's see. Now what is going to be, see? Okay, it's still giving us story 2, beam 2. Is that okay? It's still giving us story 2, beam 2. Why? Because it has not been changed from the other side. So let's see. Let's now delete this one. So that's how it is. Because of, let's save time. So that's how it is. So now let's now see how that problem can now be solved based on adjustment we have made. Let's now see. So let's go back to our story 1 and see. Now as you can see, so now let's how can we return this back to normal. So there's something we call relabeling. So relay, we are going to relabel all of this so that it will give us accurate, you know, proper numbering, so that your column 1 will be number 1, column 1, beam 2 will be beam 2, slab 1 will be slab 1. So all of those things. Now how do we go about this? How do we go about this? As I've said, so you can see this one was column 1 story 1, this one was beam 1 story 1, and this one was slab 1 story 1. So now, because of the adjustments we have made, for example, we have deleted and replaced back, so you can ask, this one is now giving us column 1 for story 1 column 41, and also beam, instead of beam 1 story 1 beam 1, it's now giving us story 1 beam 40, sorry, beam 62. So likewise, this one, instead of story 1 slab 1, is giving us story 1 slab 24. So therefore, how do we do that? Now what you need to do is to just come here straight, click on edit. When you click on edit, come to relabeling members, click on it, and then a dialog box will come up. Just here. Why? Because we have already analyzed. So now it's advisable that before you analyze, make sure after modeling, before you do your analysis, you first of all do your relabeling. Because if you do your analysis without labeling, and later you want to do labeling, this was is going to come up. So it's advisable, you first of all do your modeling. After modeling, since you know that you have made a lot of adjustments, maybe you have not made an adjustment, because the way you go about, some will first of all do the perimeter beams. And when you do the perimeter beams, you now come to what? Internal beams. You discover that based on the perimeter beam, that's how the number is going to follow. And whereas in terms of proper arrangement, it's not actually okay. You'll still be finding it difficult to locate your members. So it's very important you also carry out this after modeling, before analysis. So I'll say yes. So a dialog box will come up. So now at this point here, you see, we have column, okay, this one where I clicked before, that's why that you can see, that is why, the reason why this one, that story, if you remember, that's story two, the one we are trying to adjust, to delete and do, is because we have already done some things here before. That's why, assuming we have not done this one before, that number of story two, that the roof beam also will have changed. So therefore, since I've made adjustments on my column, so I click on column, since I've made adjustments, assuming there's wall, I made adjustments, I would have clicked on wall, but there's no wall. So what do I do? Also this one, beam. I've made adjustments on beam. I've also made adjustments on my slab. Let's assume all the things here on the wall and the rib slab, we have made adjustments. We'll have also clicked on all of them automatically. So what, having done this, what do I need to do? I'll just come here and click what? Okay. So let's wait and see the magic. So you can now see everything has come back. So you can now see beam story one, beam one. You can see column one, story one, story one, column one. You can also see our slab, story one, slab one. So you can see how everything has been properly what? Arranged. So you can see that is how to do it. So as I said, this is part one of Prota setting, and this one will help you when it comes to your Prota, you know, Prota detailing. By the time you export it to AutoCAD or to Stonebridge, you discover that you'll not find it difficult to locate your member. You can already see, you know, that from this line like this, it's your what? Story one, story two, beam one, beam two, you know, the other side beam three. Yeah, this one beam three, beam four, beam five, and then beam six, beam seven, and the rest. So based on how we are taught how to arrange it. Horizontal force followed by what? The vertical beam. So this is how to go about it. So part two will now be, how can we reduce some dimensions that if you made a mistake and export them like that into Stonebridge or AutoCAD, you still have time, you have to start deleting them one after the other, and at times if you can select all, select similar, it might also touch some dimension which are not which you are in need of. So how do you reduce that stress? How do you do that work? That will be part two of this Prota setting. So till then, don't forget to subscribe to our Ekidel channel so that you can have access to our videos. At the same time, we have a Ekidel mentorship class where we train people specially. You know, everything we have, everything we know, we'll be giving to you. It's not expensive. Likewise, I would advise you as a software engineer to also get this particular software called Stonebridge Template Detailing. It's very, very fantastic. I can't overemphasize on that particular software. Very, very important. And also, there's a software called Casesoft. case of mainly is for what? For staircase. You don't need to waste your time on that particular software. Just enter your parameter. If you know what you're doing, enter your parameters. Once you have entered the parameters, that is all. It will just be wow. Everything just come up, and if you don't even need to do anything, it will give you both the design, both the dimension, and your detailing. Everything will come out. So as a structural engineer, I would advise you to get a particular software. Till then, that we'll meet in part two of Prota setting, which will help us to remove some dimensions that are not needed in the course of our detail, so that to reduce our stress when we get to Stonebridge detailing or AutoCAD. Thank you. Till you see then. Goodbye.